Welcome to our channel Elimika Mtandaoni. We are still in the series of videos explaining about open source software adoption for healthcare organizations. I would like to tell you that this is the end, the last episode of our series of videos, and in this episode we'll be explaining about software business models. We'll be explaining about software business models, and in there you will know how you can you as an open source software developer or an open source software user, how can you benefit from the open source software. So speaking of a business model, business model explains or describes how a certain organization can create and can deliver value to its users or to its customers. For example, you are a developer of open source software, then how can you deliver value? How can you give your users or your customers better products? And it also includes how it characterizes the products or the services that a company provide, and also the way that company is being compensated. So that means with a business model, that means how can your product or your service offer to other to the users, and how will you benefit from the services that you are offering. So all of it in totality make up a business model. So business model has a number of characteristics, simply because if we create a business model of a certain company or of a certain organization, then it involves a combination of characteristics. And there are four important characteristics while creating a business model. The first one is the distribution approach. The second one is source code licenses. The third one is revenue streams and business model interaction. So we'll discuss these characteristics one after another, starting with the distribution approach. Distribution approach, in fact, this is the most important business model characteristics for business modeling, and it uses organization uses this kind of approach to provide services or to create products for its customers. So there are different approaches of which an organization can distribute its products. So if you have developed your software, then there are different ways. There are three approaches. There are three important approaches that you can opt so that you can distribute your software. Starting with the first approach is on-premise software distribution. This entails that a software, a product is being installed and is running within a client's in-house infrastructure. So it can be a single computer. So you have developed a software, let's say an open source software, then you go to the client and install it in his or her single computer, or you can user can access it on his or her local server. So that kind of an approach, we call it on-premise approach. But there is another approach that is called the cloud-based approach. This is the main characteristic. The main characteristic of the cloud-based distribution approach is that the software runs at a hosting provider or in a cloud service. For example, we have one of the cloud service approaches is called the software as a service. Software as a service is a cloud-based distribution approach in which a provider hosts its application and makes them available to the customers via the internet. So according to a software as a service approach or a software as a service method, businesses and individuals don't need to install applications on their own computers. Instead, they use applications that are installed or that are available to the servers of the owner. So they can access the software using a web browser or a mobile device. So software as A service is typically delivered via a term-based subscription method. How about this, what we call hybrid software distribution? This is a combination of software as a service solution with an on-premise software application. So a cloud-driven technology complements an on-premise software approach. So that is one among the characteristics of business model that we are talking. Another one is about source code licensing. Based on licensing of source code, then company can create a business model. So you can create a business model by looking at whether a software is proprietary, or a software is open source, or a software is free software, or a free and open source software. So it can be any of those criteria. Then let's talk about revenue streams. Let's talk about revenue streams. A software revenue stream defines the way the company is paid for its product and services. So a business model can take use of one or several revenue streams that exist out there. There are a number of revenue streams that can be adopted by open source software. One is a paid app and licenses. That means you charge a customer money for installing a software. So you go to a customer and you install a software, then you get your money. That is called paid apps and license. We have free with an app advertising. This kind of an app, in app advertising, allows you to make money by selling advertising space in your application. For example, see what Facebook does. It provides an advertising space where people can advertise through Facebook. But the Facebook application is free. We have other applications like Twitter. It is also free, but it offers some advertisements. Instagram is also the same. It is a free with in-app advertising. There is another revenue stream. We call it a sponsorship. This is a subtype of an app advertisement. In this case, you agree to become partner with an advertising company, and you provide users, your users, with some rewards for completing a certain action. For example, you tell your user, let's say, click this link so that you can get rewarded. And once a user clicks the link, then he gets some rewards. There is this other revenue stream that is called free with in-app purchases. With this kind of revenue stream, you are using your software, or you're using your product to sell other products. For example, you can use your app to advertise about your clothes that you are selling. You can advertise about food, or you can advertise about certain in-game currencies. We have another revenue stream that is called the subscriptions. Subscriptions based on customer pays as per user fee. Either a customer pays for a month use of a certain software, or a week use, or annual use, which allows that software to use that customer to use the software during that term that has been specified. If the user pays for a month, then the user is allowed to use the software for the month. We have another revenue stream called the free trial, where users can play with the product for a specific time, and at the end, he or she decides whether she should pay for subscription or leave out the software. Another type of revenue stream, we call it freemium. This is a combination of free and paid versions. That means a software is given to a user, and user uses that software with the two features. The first features are few, and some premium features. So if a user wants to use some premium features, then he or she must pay for the paid version of the software. There is this other revenue stream that we call the usage-based license. Usage-based license, clients subscribe to a pay-as-you-go license based upon some measure of consumption. How much has user used your product? Then he pays basing on the measure of consumption. We have another revenue stream that we call a transcription. We have another transaction fee. This is called the transaction fee. This company charges a commission based on the volume for enabling or executing a certain a transaction. After a certain transaction has been done, then there is a commission that is given to the person whom the service is paid or is used to. We have business model interactions. These software companies inevitably choose between two types of business models interactions while forming its business model. So it can take different forms. It can be either one to many or many to many interaction. And the two most common ways of business model interactions are business to business or business to consumers. So you can either sell to another business or you can sell to a consumer. So those are the characteristics of our business model. Remember, we have talked about a number of characteristics of a business model. We started with the distribution approach. We followed with the source code licensing. Then we discussed about revenue streams and business model interactions. Under revenue streams, we have seen a number of revenue streams that include free trial, subscriptions, freemium, usage-based, transaction fee, etc. And under source code licensing, we have seen that a software can be presented to the user as a proprietary software or as open source software. And lastly, we have discussed about business model interactions where the business choose between two types of business models interactions, and in the end it forms either one-to-one or many-to-many interactions. And the most common types of interactions are business-to-business or business-to-consumer interactions. So this is the end of the series of videos on open source software adoption for healthcare organizations. We have been together for a number of videos. So thank you for being with us. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you that you are sharing, you are commenting, you are liking. Remember, you are given this knowledge for free. So you just have to subscribe. You just have to watch. That is enough. So thank you very much. This is Elimika Mtandaoni, and I'm your presenter, Agustino Mogos.